Most people don't typically prepare for the unexpected, but the pandemic showed how important it is to prioritize your future. Financial planning is something that's especially important. Financial advisor Steve Lewit joining us now with some tips on how to prepare for your future. Hello, Steve. How are you?
Well, thank you. I'm good.
Good. A lot of people say keep money away for a rainy day, but how do you do that when you're paying off bills, especially since the pandemic, which caused a lot of problems for people?
Yeah, rainy day funds are really important because things happen. You know, cars break down, the plumbing breaks, you might need a new roof or new windows. And for some people, that's really hard. We recommend 3 to 6 months of income if it's possible. If it's hard for you, then you have to start saving some money. And even if you're saving a little bit each month, just make it a habit and start saving. Pay down those credit cards little by little until you can generate a rainy day fund, because at some point, something is going to happen. You know that. It always does.
It does. Start small. What do you mean by small? 100, 200, 50?
Well, if you have your budget, and I recommend everybody, nobody likes to do a budget. And how many people say, I can't wait to do a budget. But if you have a budget and you can squeeze out $10, $100, $50 a month, whatever you can squeeze out, it's make sure you do that. Put that in a savings account and then promise yourself you're not going to touch it. And you'll be amazed little by little that builds up and all of a sudden you have a rainy day fund.
What about documents, insurance and things like that? Should we be doing that now?
Absolutely. You know, again, prepare. What if you're in a coma? What if you get hit by a car? Do you have Do you have your health care powers of attorney? Do you have your financial powers of attorney so somebody can make decisions for you? I'm going to say this too. What if you pass away? Do you have a trust or a will so your money goes to your kids or to your heirs exactly where it wants to go? All your documents, your insurances, your social security cards, are they all in one place? Or is it a place that people know where it is? And this is all to prepare yourself and your family. If something goes wrong and you're incapable or unable, they know what to do and you know they have your back.
And the thing about that too is have the actual physical document, but make electronic copies too, right?
Yeah, there are lots of, good point. There are lots of portals now where you can upload these documents. They're very secure, they're very safe, and that's a backup. So let's say you're overseas or you're on a vacation and something happens and you need a power of attorney, you can go right into the backup and download it, and there you have it, and everything is in place for you.
Now, what about passwords? Because you need to share those passwords or nobody can get those things, right, electronically.
That's right. Passports are the most, I like to tell my clients, look, if you're going to protect anything, protect your passport. It has to be in a very safe place in your home. If you're carrying it with you, you want to wear, I always wear one of those fanny pack on it, right? So nobody in the front, so nobody can grab it. But you can upload those documents to a secure site, so at least the pictures of it are available for you.
And passwords, too, are important to share to your significant others and family members, right?
Again, you're preparing for a time that you're not there or you're incapable. So if someone doesn't know your passwords, there are we provide a book to our clients. We say, here, this is your password book,
gotcha.
And this is where you put it. In a secure vault, maybe in a fireproof container or water, someplace safe. So if something happens to you and somebody's got to get into your computer or get into your phone, they have the passwords, or get into your bank accounts or your investment accounts. They have the passwords to get into it. Otherwise, they can't help you.
And what's that website where we can call so we can put everything in one place?
It's called a vault, and there are different vaults that you can find on the internet that you can upload. They're secure vaults.
Thank you, Steve Lewit. Appreciate it. Be safe, be well.
Okay, you too. Thank you. Mm-hmm.